main card for this Saturday, which the first fight will be a lightweight matchup between Luis Pena, who is 8-3 and is the -150 favorite, going up against Alexander Munoz, who is 6-1 and the +125 underdog. What do you see in this matchup?
Yeah, this is a great matchup with two guys who don't have a problem letting it go to the judges. Pena has been more comfortable with letting the fight go three rounds rather than he has previously. And he recently switched gyms. He was with AKA for a very long time, I think since The Ultimate Fighter, where he was working with DC and Khabib and those guys over there. And now he's moved all the way over to Florida. He's doing American Top Team. So I expect to see a different approach from Lewis. Munoz, on the other hand, is an intriguing fighter coming out of Team Alpha Male. Munoz is good on his feet and can finish the fight early. However, lately he has been going the distance as well in his last four fights. I believe they were all decision fights. I see Munoz trying to push the pace, whereas I see Pena trying to take it to the ground and get the submission. In this fight, which it could go either way, I'm going with the cooler nickname and one of my favorite fighters, who's Luis Pena, Violent Bob Ross. So I'm expecting Pena to showcase his skills and get the decision win. I think this goes all three rounds.
Yeah, like this is an interesting fight. You got Pena coming in at 4-3 in the UFC, and then you got Munoz. He's coming in at 6-1. Just like you said, Pena is more of the grappler. He's going to want to get on the ground, whereas Munoz, he's going to want to stand up. He does the switch stance. So when he fights, he keeps switching his stances. That's usually what he tries to do to combat his opponent. And just like you said, he's going to want to pick the pace up. And interestingly enough, Munoz averages 2 takedowns per fight. So usually he would want to go for the takedown, but I think in this fight, it'd be wise for him not to. With the Pena's grappling expertise, he'll just get caught in a submission, or he can make a mistake when taking him down, and it might work against him. Where he's the more polished striker, even though Pena's not that bad of a striker, I think accuracy wise, Pena's better with his hands, but just volume wise, Munoz will get off more. And it'll be more effective. But I'm in agreement with you. I think Pena is going to win this. I think he's going to get him down to the ground. And I actually think this is going to be a second round rear naked choke by Luis Pena.
Oh, nice. Yeah. I'm really curious about this fight because I want to see the change that Luis Pena has gone through going from AKA to American Top Team. You see when fighters go from one gym to ATT, the change is drastic. I feel like it's one of those things where there's so many great fighters and up and coming great fighters that you really have to be on your A game, and you can get comfortable in another gym. So kind of switching it up, as long as there's no bad blood between Luis Pena. I believe at one point he was living with Daniel Cormier. Yeah. I love Luis Pena's story, his name, you know, all that stuff where he met his dad at one of his fights. He had never seen his dad. He's got a very great story, but I'm curious to see if the Team Alpha Male comes out in Munoz, where he's just constantly shooting for takedowns, because that's a wrestle-heavy gym over there. But I'm going to still ride with Pena in this one.
Yeah, I could see that, but luckily with him having a grappling background, that's a really good thing with the American Top Team. They're known for that.
Yeah,
you have guys like Michael Chandler who shoots himself, but
Amaro, Gilbert Burns.
Gilbert Burns, Amaro, Usman used to be there before he went to Denver. But you have a bunch of guys there that he can learn from and get a different aspect of the game, the more of the grappling instead of the wrestling. I always think of that as the wrestling sambo camp. And then you got American Top Team, which is more of the grappling. So I can see why he made the move. He wants to get more into his wheelhouse grappling. And I don't think that they probably made a big deal about it. They knew that he probably needed a change of scenery because he was 4-3 in the UFC. So
yeah, and they're both coming off a loss. Mm-hmm. That's very interesting to see who's going to get on track. Kamal Worthy and Nasrat Hosparasat, the Kelvin Gastelum lookalike. That was the last two losses. So I'm curious to see who gets back on track, and it's going to be a good fight. It's a good way to kick off the fight. But also, the first fight of the night is our friend Anthony Bircek. So I'm riding for him too. I think you have an interview coming up tomorrow with him. So that's going to be super interesting. I'm very excited for his fight as well.
Yep, that'll be released tomorrow at noon.
Yeah.
So definitely check that.